Let's go!
Yes, you are. The singing again and again. You step down into darkness. Open my eyes, let me see beauty that made this heart adore me.
Thank you. Jesus. Now because the band have been here taking quite a lot of praise and worship, we will just take a brief of it again and we take the next item on the program. Street State is not as large as we'll be able to contain the crowd that will want to pay the last respect. So that's why we brought out the cops to the open arena. When we get to that time, we'll just file round and we'll officially
that are here in this meeting. And we will not fail to recognize the one who by his mercies and grace we are standing, we are living, and we are gathered in this place. The one who by his mercies has granted us life, enablement, and strength to do what we are doing today. And at this time, will we welcome and recognize the presence of the Lord Jesus Christ in our midst. Join me as we clap to the glory of God, the welcoming of Jesus in this assembly. And as you do that, can we say praise to the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Here we have ordained ministers of the gospel. We have elders that are also ordained. We want to recognize every ordained minister that is here. We will not be able to call you by name, but we know that you are here. The anointing of God is upon your head. We also want to say you're welcome to this occasion. And for the elders that also are here, the ordained elders, either in the ministry or elsewhere, in some places they call them the deacons, we also want to say you're welcome in this very occasion. I want to make some recognition, one after the other, just briefly. And you that is here, you're most recognized. Wherever you're seated, where you're seated is called high chair. If there is a table before you, it's called high table. So you're recognized in your high chair and in your high table. And we want to recognize the presence of our area minister that is able seated here with us. She's the one on whose zone we are under. That is the area minister. Join me as we make welcome the area minister of Transamani area, our mother, Evangelist Miriam Ohola. Can we clap hands together? And also, we recognize the presence of our father. He is in charge of the Calvary Prayer Forum. It's no other one than our brother, Elder Benny Okoma, and your family, the wife, and we put our hands together. And also we have representative from the Central Elders Council. Join me as we welcome Elder Emmanuel Uruene from the center. And also from the area, we have a representative of the elders. Join me as I welcome the area chairman for the elders, Elder Maxwell Njoku.
Praise the Lord!
Then on the officiating list, we have the zonal minister in charge of the zone that our mother worships with. Join me as we recognize our brother, Pastor Peter Sokou Akanibo. Let's put our hands together. And also to recognize in that light is Pastor Abraham Jeremiah. Pastor Lebo Vite, also to recognize the former zonal minister and the resident pastor, is on the facility list. Our father, Evangelist Ella L.K. Amakri, is here as an officiating minister and also will be duly recognized for the tankers to the fullness. And also our brother, Evangelist Vincent Aderagi, who is also to recognize Pastor Reni Kuki, Pastor Omyedi Iliwari, and Pastor Obwene John the next on our list. We take the opening hymn for today's gathering as we sing from SSNS 798, Sacred Psalms and Solos 798, and we will do that as the band is of it.
Faith in our way, the light we stand.
one end and exit from the other end. We don't want traffic jam here. No road safety that will control us. But I want somebody who can direct the crowd from one end so that we can do that peacefully and quietly and to save time. So, we have to
Elder Paulina Sekin Jaja Amakri, who was born in the year 15th of January 1954, into the family of late Mr. and Mrs. Godson Maguagu of Umuaga Agua in Uguta, local government area of Imo State. Elder Paulina Jaja Amakri is the first child of the fifth girl, daughter of nine children. At the tender age, Elder Paulina Sekin Jaja Amakri was adopted into the family of late Chief Sekin Jaja Amakri in Asarutaru local government area of Buduma in Calabari Land by late Obialeba Desti Jaja Amakri, where she became the last child of four children. Elder Paulina Sekin Jaja Amakri survived by seven children. Her educational life is as follows. Late Mrs. Elder Paulina Sekin Jaja Amakri had a zeal for education and passion for knowledge. She attended Zion Primary School in Owerri, Agua, in Iguta local government in Imo State, before moving with her adoptive parents to Buguma, where she attended Our Savior's Primary School. And later, in her 30s, she attended Adult Education Center in Port Harcourt, where she advanced her passion for knowledge and a zeal to learn. Her work life goes as thus. Late Mrs. Elder Paulina Sekin Jaja Amakri was an industrious and hardworking woman who was full of business ideas and energy to strive in life. She wanted to strive in all aspects of business and she was involved in. She was successful right from her early age. She became an independent and ambitious woman, specifically around trading, bread making, necklace making, jewelries, and other trend of is too numerous to mention. She taught her children how to be productive in business. She was determined in life and God gave her the grace to strive. In her Christian life, late Mrs. Elder Paulina Sekin Jaja Amakri gave her life to Christ in 1990 in Buguma, when Greater Evangelism World Crusade was doing a rally in the streets of the town, and ever since then, she has not deviated from that path and has been faithful to the church with activities and commitments. On the 2nd of June 2018, she was ordained as an elder by the present director, Pastor Isaac B. Olori. She was also an usher in a local zone. Socially, late Elder Paulina Sekin Jaja Amakri was a rare gem, a woman full of love, compassion, and caring heart, demonstrating these qualities to everyone who came her path. She was very supportive in advice to others that are close to her, and even people she barely knew. She was always with a smile on her face, and never would she accept discrimination of any kind. As the Bible says, givers never lack. She was a giver, and she never lacked. She was fond of giving everyone that comes close to her home food, no matter how well she knows them, even strangers she met on the road. She would give them a home, give them food, and sometimes financial assistance. She was a kind-hearted person. She was a kind-hearted person that one would like to come across. She never eats alone. She's a giver and a loving mother. Thank you all.
Citation by GWC Central Elders Council.
I will call the area chairman of Ugu to read the citation.
Okay, right.
67 years. Late Elder Mrs. Paulina Amakri was born on 15th January 1954. She came in contact with the Ministry of Greater Evangelism World Crusade and got born again in 1972 in Buguma City and was baptized by a mansion in 1974 by Apostle G.D. Numbere. Having joined the Ministry of Greater Evangelism World Crusade, she was expunged to certain basic Christian lessons, including but not limited to the studies of the arts and science of a newfound faith as a durable platform to secure, enhance, and guarantee a victorious Christian living after a repentance till a glorious encore on the 24th of August 2021. Again, having fully identified herself with the ministry of Greater Evangelism World Crusade, she continued to dedicate herself to the service of God Almighty, being zealous and fervent in spirit. She was nominated for eldership ordination. Being successful in the exercise, she was ordained an elder on the 2nd June 2018 by Pastor Isaac Valentine Olori, International Director of Greater Evangelism World Crusade. Late Elder Mrs. Paulina Amakri left behind her footprint in the kingdom race, dedication, and commitment in the service of God. She lived a total of 67 years on earth, 49 years in active service, and in the vineyard, 3 years in the council. The council, therefore, by reason of a victorious service rendered to the ministry in a lifetime, host this flag in her honor and use it as a coverage of her mortal body. At her dismind and thereafter be presented to the family for memorial. Ladies and gentlemen, men and brethren, indeed, in this sinful and adulterous generation of vipers, this battle of faith was gallantly fought and won on a clean slate by our departed elder. Good night and farewell, our dear colleague. This citation was signed by Pastor Elder K.L. Winnie, the International, the Central Elders Council Chairman. Thank you.
Having completed that assignment by the Central Elders Council, we are now going to the next stage of the program, and that is offering.
I.S. Wokoma to take the lesson.
We have taken our lesson from two different books. We are taking the first one from 2 Kings chapter 6, verse 1 to 7. I read. The company of the prophets said to Elisha, "Look, the place where we meet with you is too small for us. Let us go to the Jordan, where each of us can get a pool, and let us build a place where there for us to live." And they said, "Go." Then one of them said, "Won't you please come with your servants?" "I will," Elisha replied, and he went with them. They went to the Jordan and began to cut down trees. 5. As one of them was cutting down a tree, the iron as head fell into the water. "Oh, my Lord," he cried out, "it was borrowed. Say, The man of God asked, where did it fell? When he showed him the place, Elijah caught a stick and threw it there and made the iron flow. Lift it out, he said. Then the man reached out his hand and took it. 7. Praise the Lord. Let's go to the second passage. And that's in the New Testament. Luke chapter 12, verse 16 to 21. New Testament. 12:16-21. I read. And he told them this parable. The ground of a certain rich man produced a good crop. He thought to himself, what shall I do? I have no place to store my crops. 18. Then he said, this is what I will do. I will tear down my barns and build bigger ones. And there I will store all my grain and my goods. And I will say to myself, you have plenty of good things laid up for many years. Take life easy. Eat, drink, and be merry. 20. But God said to him, you fool, this very night your life will be demanded from you. Then who will get what you have prepared for yourself? 21. The last. This is how it will be with anyone who stores up things for himself, but is not rich towards God. Praise the Lord. May the Lord bless the reading of his word in Jesus' name.
The horses and the chariots are made ready for battle, but victory in each sense belongs to God. I believe the choir, you have a peace to render. Am I correct? No peace, okay. So at this time, I want us to bow our heads because we want to hear the word of God. Father, we thank you for this privilege you have given unto us to hear from you. Lord, we ask, my Father, your word is the entrance of your word given light. We ask that your word will bring light even to the heart of the simple. Speak to us, not in parables, not in proverbs, but in the clarities of your word. Thank you that your word will profit us in the name of Jesus. Can we put our hands together as our welcome to the rostrum speaker and our father for today's meeting, Evangelist Lolo K. Amakri. You can do better and encourage him as he takes his place.
Especially thank our area minister, Evangelist Miriam Okova, and our zonal minister, Pastor Soko Akanibo, and all the dignitaries who are here and who have granted me the permission that I should deliver the word of God to this congregation this afternoon. I want to greet all the chiefs, the traditional rulers, our mothers and fathers from Calabar Land and Buguma in particular, who are here on this commendation service in respect of our dear sister and elder, Paulina Seki Jaja Amakri, Yama Rosite. The passages of scripture which we read just this afternoon before I came up to this stage in 2 Kings chapter 6, verses 1 to 7, and St. Luke's Gospel chapter 6, chapter 12, verses 16 to 21. These two passages have some similarities, and they also have some dissimilarities, that is, areas that the two passages look alike and areas that they do not look alike. The two passages are talking first about Elisha, the servant of God, and the sons of the prophets. And the second passage in St. Luke's Gospel chapter 12 talks about a parable, that is, a very point that our Lord Jesus Christ told to his disciples. I want to talk about the areas in which the two passages are similar. First of all, the sons of the prophets realized that where they were dwelling, living together with Elisha, the servant of God, was too tight for them. In other words, the place was not accommodating them again. Maybe the number of the sons of prophets have become so many that the accommodation became too small for them. Also, we find that the rich man, the man the Bible talks about in St. Luke's Gospel, chapter 12, the Bible described him as a rich man, a worldly rich man. And the Bible says that he realized that his barn, that is the place where he stored his goods and his wealth, had become so tight. The barn was not big enough to accommodate his harvest, his goods, and his wealth.
It was too small for them.
He could not accommodate them. And the place where the rich man also stored his harvest, his goods, and his wealth was also too small, because he has acquired so much goods and his harvest. Next, we see that the sons of the prophets, they told Elisha that he should permit them, they asked for permission from their master, Elisha, to allow them to go to the river or to the sea and cut down sticks of wood which they will use to build a bigger accommodation for them to. That the rich man decided to build a bigger barn, a bigger small house, for all his goods, because he saw that his barn was small.
Praise the Lord. They did not just go on their own to go and begin to look for building materials to come and build the house they wanted to live in. But they recognized that he was God's servant and he had God's authority in his hand. So they sought his permission. They did not go on their own to do whatever they thought they should do. Secondly, the rich man himself, who was wise in his own heart, he did not think there is a God or there is God at all. So, the Bible tells us in St. Luke's Gospel chapter 12, verse 17 and 18, that he thought within himself that he is his own God. He thought within himself. He thought it out by himself. He took a personal decision. It was his own mind, his own thoughts, his own convictions that he followed. He did not think that God was there and that he needed to consult God or meet the servant of God, somebody that represented God, to hear from a God's representative before he could carry out anything that he thought to do. Now, the next area in which these two people's attitudes are not similar is that in the case of the sons of the prophets, when they ask, that is the head of the ass fell into the water, they remember the presence of God's representative. The ass head, Calabar people will call it the kumbusirime. When the ass head fell from the hand, we have heard a lot of stories about her. Some pastors came to the commendation service in our church at Wojitown on Wednesday this week, and they were testifying how Polina was a very good woman to them. When she saw them, she would always give a helping hand to them, giving dashing money to pastors, assisting pastors, helping them. She was very friendly with whosoever came her way. Even in the biography that have been read here, we have heard how she always wore a smile on her face and was very hard working. Polina has a very large family. We have seen her children, that God bless her, that she had as many as 7 children. And these children, as we have seen, they are very good children, praise the Lord, and very resourceful. At Port Harcourt, Elder Polina has a building where she was living with the members of her family, praise the Lord. So, she had a very resourceful family and worked very, very hard in her. She was a trader, worked very hard. She made beads and she sold clothing. Now, in doing all these things that Elder Polina did, she realized that her life, that is her soul, the power of life, the power that she exercised in doing everything that she did, the strength of life that she had to do all that she did, that it came from God.
God told the rich man that he is what? A fool.
And that is exactly what you are. If you have the mindset of that rich man, I want to tell you today that whatsoever is not your own is not under your control. Amen. 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 God says that our soul, your soul, belongs to Him. Amen. And since it belongs to God, it means you cannot control it. You are not the one that is going to determine how long you are going to live on earth. Your life is not your own. God owns it. And at His own time, He will come and take it. God Almighty will soon come and take that power of life that you are living and exercising and boasting about and saying, I will do this, I will do that. After I finish doing this, I will do this next one. I will do this, I will do that. That power, God who owns it, will come and take it. And in fact, at the time you want to enjoy it most, that is when God comes to take it away. Especially when you are using it in a way not recognizing Him. When you use it without resorting to God, without recognizing that you are not your own, that God owns you, and that whenever He likes, He can come and take that life from you. That is what happened to the rich man. And that is what is going to happen to all the people who are self-conceited, who are self-willed, who are always boasting on what they can do, and who are striving and working hard and as if life is in their hands. The day that God will come and take the life away from you, you will not know, you'll be surprised. You'll be shocked that suddenly what is happening to you is what they call death. And when you die, you do not know where you are going. Well, Apollina, her time on earth was completed. Praise the Lord. She spent all her time on this earth recognizing God as her creator and submitting her life to Jesus Christ, the Son of God. For the Bible says there is no other way under heaven
even among my wife and we must be saved. The only way to be united to God who created us, the only way to hand over our soul to the Creator, to the Maker, is by accepting Jesus Christ as our Lord and personal Savior. While you are still breathing, this is your opportunity. And I want to plead with you today. Please let this day we are remembering the good life that Elder Paulina lived on earth. Let it be day when you also will decide to surrender your life to Jesus Christ.
Amen.
So that from today henceforth, you will live for God. Amen.
Amen.
You will live for Jesus Christ. You will serve God with all your heart. Give your heart to Him and live for Him. So that on the day when the owner of your soul will come, you will not regret. You will rejoice that you have lived your life for Him. Amen. And that you are going back to Him. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
So right now, we are going to pray. And if you are convinced in your heart that this is an opportunity for you to also give your life to Jesus Christ, and that Elder Paulina's life will be a good example to you. For look at the elders of greater evangelism, what we say. See how they came out here commending Elder Paulina for the life that she lived. She did not live outside Jesus Christ, but she lived inside Christ, because Jesus Christ guided and directed her life all through her days. If you want God to be happy with you, the way He is also happy with Elder Paulina, I want you to rise up so that we can pray together. Shall we close our eyes in prayer? We want to pray now. All of you, you want to give your life to Christ. You want to summon on this commendation service of your daughter, Elder Paulina Amakri. The very words, oh God Almighty, that you lay in our hearts, we have shared with your children, your own creation, whom you created and brought them forth here in this world, in the island of Buguma, in Seki Jaja Amakri's compound. Everlasting Father, your word has gone out, and it is written, your word that goeth forth out of your mouth shall not return unto you void. It shall prosper in the thing whereto you have sent it, and it shall accomplish your purpose. Therefore, mighty God, as many as have had this word, I command it into your hands now. Everlasting Father, let your word not return unto you void, but let the word do the work you have sent it in the hearts of all those who have had the word today. I pray thee, Almighty God, that you will bless every soul that have had these words today with salvation, that they will give their lives to Jesus Christ and be born again from this day henceforth, that their lives be transformed, and that they will realize that their souls are borrowed, that God is the one that gave them in this of life they are living. And any day that you choose, you will also take them away from this world. Almighty God, I pray thee, let your Holy Spirit, the Spirit of truth, do this in their hearts by saving their souls, Almighty God, in the name of Jesus Christ.
Represented to come out here for the prayers. Let another person go so that you don't go lost in action. We don't want to be missing in action. Please, can I have a soft tune for that, please? Particularly those males that we want to be like peacock. I want to say too heavy, eh? Let me send the message. At this point, we want to welcome the area minister in charge of the Transamadi area, who under this zone is planted. She will do two assignments before she leaves this place. She will pray for the family, and by God's grace, she will also do the interment. Can we put our hands together as we welcome to the rostrum our mother, Evangelist Miriam.
That God's servant has spoken to your hearts. I want you to hear this word. But I want you to know the life you're living is not your own. You might be very strong today. You must have seen the entire world and whatever it takes to be alive. But always remember that it's a borrowed life. Anytime, any day, the owner of life can demand it. No thought of others. Where will you spend eternity? Just like God's servant has told us. The world will say, "Pata pata man, there you go." It is not so. When your eye closes here, it opens somewhere. Don't ever finish this simple ceremony of your mom without meeting with your maker. Everyone seated anywhere. Just make sure you don't live here without knowing that the life you are living is not your own. Just bear that in mind. The rich man was not called a fool because he had money. It is God that gives us the power to make wealth. But he was called a fool because he didn't know that he was living a borrowed life. I just pray that God will teach us and we shall understand the mysteries of his word. Let us pray. On Christ the soul
upon man the bread of life and man became a living being. The custodian of the mystery of ages. The landlord of the universe. The owner of life. We bow in our hearts with humility of heart to worship. We thank you so much because from the foundation of the world, you have known that we shall gather to send forth this your child. You brought her to the world, and it pleases you that she returns back to you. So Lord, we come to say thank you. And we say you are worthy. And you'll still be our God to the close of the age. And now we bring the family before you. For Lord, we know that except you keep, except you build. We know that you are the only strong rock. We know that you are the shelter. You are the place of refuge. Our strength and our refuge you are. We know that you are the very, very present hope in time of trouble. And we know that when we run under you, we are safe and we are secure. We are very much aware that whatever is committed into your hands is safe. So Lord, we bring the children. We bring the grandchildren. You are the God that preserves. You are the God that delivers. And you are the one that defends. We bring them under the covenant of defense. We bring them under the covenant of deliverance and preservation. And we ask that you preserve them. That you be a mother and a father to them. Dear Lord, we pray like David. That you deliver their soul from death. Deliver their eyes from shedding unnecessary tears. And that you deliver their feet from falling. And we decree they will not fall, they will not fail, they will not stumble, and they will not falter. But the Lord, they will stand to serve you in the land of the living. Lord, we stand in the name of He that is above every other name. And we break the yoke of premature death.
Amen.
We break the yoke of premature death.
Amen.
Lord, we break the yoke of premature death in this family. And we decree that they will live to fulfill their days.
Amen.
They will live, O God, according to your word, full old age. And Lord, every link between them and the dead be broken by the power of the Holy Ghost. And we ask, oh God, that you keep them safe and keep them secure. And the Lord God Almighty, you be their God and be their Father. And that you become everything to them. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Praise the Lord. Let's do the what we can.
Now when the children grow up to ask what to say. Our mother's faith. So keep his faith. Keep his faith. So that you be a real warrior to your family. So we present it to you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Thank you.
Praise the Lord.
From Oji to Rainbow, sometimes you are passing, you see her. Very hard working. In order to train the children, in order to help the children. She was a good advisor to her children and to the church. She loved God so much. No matter the distance, she will come. Even if she's late, she will still come. And then when she comes with smiles, she will be laughing. You know, because of her laughing and she won't, if she wants to get that herself, she will not be able to get angry again. And then she gets angry sometimes too. But she immediately will apologize to you. That's what I learned from her. Then coming to Calamari Brethren, we used to move together to church. She loved Calamari dance, Calamari song, even in the church. If you have special song, she's coming out for Thanksgiving. You see her dancing and
for the boys.
She loves everybody. She takes everybody like her own child. Even when she goes out and sees people like they are struggling, she will bring them home, give them food, give them money to start up a business. She's a loyal girl. Before my mom died, she was like, she actually said she wants to sleep. And she prayed. After praying, she slept and prayed. I thank God that before she died, she prayed. We are so blessed.
You told me that I really can. I praise you for want to express my love for my mother and my appreciation for everyone that has made it here today. Thank you so much. Thank you for making the journey down to Buguma. I especially want to thank the ministers of Great Evangelism World Crusade. They have been amazing. They've demonstrated honor. They've demonstrated brotherhood, sisterhood, unity. They've showed us what the Christian life is. They've gone over and beyond for my mother. And I pray that God will honor them individually, one after the other. I want to thank all the friends and family that are here. Thank you so much for coming. My mother is going to be with the Lord. It is actually a part, a sad part. But I want to appreciate God because she's going to a better place. I want to thank the elders. They've actually been strongly behind her. I'm not sure where they're sitting. Yeah. So thank you so much, everyone, every one of you. God will honor you. Thank you so much. Your children will honor you. Thank you so much. I really appreciate you all. Thank you so much to the band. Thank you for the elders that are here at the foot. Thank you so much. I cannot even thank you enough, but I know that my mother will be looking down and smiling at today because she has seen you in the unified front. And she knows that indeed she's going to be with Jesus. Thank you all. Praise the Lord.
Take 3 and 4 stand and 3 and 4.
Of a saint
must not in any way be desecrated. God is interested in us, whether we live or die. Praise the Lord. Kindly turn with me to 1 Thessalonians chapter 4. We'll be taking 13 to 18.
Verse 13. Okay. But I will not have you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep.
I don't want to keep you in dark.
That,
concerning them that are asleep.
That ye sorrow not, even as others which have no hope.
That when a child of God dies, he sleeps.
For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so then also, we sleep in Jesus, will God bring with him. For this we say unto you, by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a loud shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. We therefore comfort one another with these words.
Comfort one another with these words. We have had the gospel. Please, can we be quiet now? And on that morning, this carcass cannot be back. A dead in Christ will be lifted. They will rise first. As Peter said, we do not of all that are alive and remain. We that are alive and remain. Remaining in strength. Remaining in Christ. Will also be cut off. And that is the reason why we do not sorrow. I want you to know that if you have this hope of resurrection, you begin to purify yourself. Sure, sure, Jesus is returning. There is no controversy. Wherever you take this body to, wherever the burial ground is, when at the voice of that trumpet of the Lord, the grace will not be hard. I want you to make sure that you are partaker of this glorious event that will soon come to pass. Praise the Lord. I say praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Who is doing business is to take back to himself the soul of our beloved Elder Pauline from Akron. We therefore commit his body to the ground. Up to heaven. Ashes. Dust. And the sure and certain hope that the spirit which has returned unto God, who gave it, will be reunited with our resurrected body at the sound of the coming of the Lord. When the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trumpet of God. For the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible. For this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. Then shall come to pass the same that is written, dead,
in the morning of resurrection. And that is the reason why the great evangelism work, we say we are so grateful for this morning. But this body was not in any way. Now we ask that especially you, children, help us hope in the resurrection.
Praise the Lord.
Dedication to our Father that has got to be with the Lord. Paulina. We want to wish our mommy farewell. And to all the mothers that is here. And if you know you love your mother, this song is for you.
Sweet mother, I never forget you. What is over with is over for me. Sweet mother, I never forget you. What is over with is over for me.
Sweet mother.
This cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace, when fears are still, when striving cease. My comforter, my all in all, here in the love of Christ I stand. Ooh. Oh,
the world, you step down into darkness. Open my eyes, let me see.
Sweet mother, I never forget you, so my way is so my body, yeah. Sweet mother, sweet mother.
Here I am to worship.